Hachette Audio presents Treasure Hunters, Danger Down the Nile. Written by James Patterson and Chris Grabenstein. Read by Brian Kennedy. Includes a Mac and PC compatible PDF of illustrations by Juliana Neufeld. A quick note from Bickford Kidd. First off, nobody calls me Bickford except my twin sister, Rebecca. And even then, only when she's really mad at me. Second, you should know that I, Bick Kidd, will be the one telling you this story, while my sister, Beck, will be doing the drawings. Like the first one in the PDF. Beck just said I have to tell you not to believe everything I say either, especially if it's about her. Like my snarky comment about her snarky comments. Fine. Now, can we get on with the story? Hold on tight. This could be a wild ride. Hey, with us kids, most rides are. Prologue. Bottoming out. 1. All my life, we kids have lived on the sea. Then, one day, we almost died under it. The four of us were crammed inside a two-person mini-sub, what the U.S. Navy calls a DSV, or Deep Submergence Vehicle, our newest piece of high-tech treasure hunting gear. We'd purchased it at an auction with the $500,000 reward we collected on our last adventure. My big sister, Storm, was convinced we needed the submarine to help us in our continuing quest to bring home the two most important treasures in the world, our missing mom and dad. See, Storm doesn't dive, because the last time she climbed into a rubber scuba suit, some mean old geezer on a yacht called her a shrink-wrapped whale. Obviously, that little comment wasn't his best idea, because the next time he went to take his fancy yacht for a spin, the fish head in your bedsheet smell was getting pretty bad. Nobody messes with Storm. We still needed Storm's photographic memory if we wanted to go back to the pair of sunken Spanish galleons off the coast of Florida that our father, the world-famous treasure hunter, Dr. Thomas Kidd, had dubbed the Twins. That was why we were packed like sardines in the DSV. Unfortunately, Mom and Dad weren't with us. The ship's cargo holds were loaded down with treasure, enough to finance Kid Family Treasure Hunters, Inc., for as long as it took to figure out some way to help our parents, who, on top of being world-class treasure hunters, were neck-deep in dangerous CIA business. So finding those ships was crazy important. But Tommy had lost the treasure map that took us to the Twins the first time. Well, if we were being honest, he accidentally used it as a napkin for a greasy slice of pizza, then crumpled it up and tossed it into a trash barrel. A trash barrel he and one of his assorted girlfriends used later for a beach bonfire. So it was pretty much gone for good.
"This sub is awesome," said Tommy,
who's 17 and the closest thing we have to adult supervision.
"The four of us can dive as a family without messing up our hair."
"Or breathing,"
added Beck, who was squished up against a porthole.
"Change your heading to 263 degrees, Tommy," said Storm, navigating from memory. "The sunken vessels will be dead ahead."
"Aye, aye,"
said Tommy. But when he nudged the control stick forward, the ship didn't budge. We kept drifting downward, sinking deeper and deeper. How far down can this thing go without popping a gasket? I asked.
4,500 meters, said Storm. That's 14,764 feet, for those of you who skipped the math chapter on metric conversions. Maybe we should go back up to the Lost, suggested Beck. And, oh, I don't know, read the operating manual?
Yeah, said Tommy. That'd be a good idea. Make all preparations for surfacing. Secure the ventilation. Shut bulkhead flappers.
Yep, Tommy sure sounded like a real live submarine commander. Too bad we kept sinking.
Those controls aren't working either,
Tommy finally said, after nothing he flipped or poked worked. So basically, I said, all we can do is keep going down? To the bottom of the sea? Tommy nodded.
Basically.
That was when our engines cut out. We've lost power, Storm reported matter-of-factly. If you have a favorite prayer, now would be a good time to start reciting it. Remember how Tommy said that thing about the sub making it easier for us to dive as a family? Well, it looked like it might help us die as a family, too. 2. We kept drifting down.
Goodbye, cruel world, said Storm,
who's sort of known for blurting out whatever is on her mind whenever it happens to be there.
Tell Neptune to stick his forked trident in our butts, because we're done. It's all over but the crying, except, of course, I refuse to do it.
Hey, hang on, said Tommy. We're the kids. We live for dangerous adventures like this. Death-defying explorations are the crazy glue that holds us together. Sure, sometimes we get down, but we always get back up. And we're never, ever defeated.
Yes, my big brother was being a rock, or a blockhead. I mean, seriously, we were in deep trouble, like almost all the way down to the bottom of the ocean deep.
You know, Tommy, said Beck, you kind of remind me of Dad, bucking us up like that. It's sweet.
Tommy gave her his dimpled grin.
Thanks, Beck.
It's also kind of tragic, added Storm, especially given the timing. However, since we still have a few hours of oxygen left, we have plenty of time to contemplate our coming deaths while ruminating on the things in life that we'll miss the most. For me, it's a toss-up. Malamars or Krispy Kremes. Oh, tough call, Storm, Beck said. I have to give it to the classic Malamar, though.
What about Mom and Dad? I said. That's what I'll miss. Pirates in Cyprus had kidnapped our mother. Our father had been missing ever since we battled a terrifying tropical storm off the coast of the Cayman Islands. I had, with our Uncle Timothy's help, sent a fake email from Dad to his kids, but that hadn't completely convinced everyone he was still alive. Storm set her jaw.
Dad is already dead, Bick. You need to accept that fact and move on. Where's he going to move to? Said Beck. We're squished inside here like Pokemon trapped inside a Pokeball.
Storm's right, said Tommy with a sigh. Dad's waiting for us down below in Davy Jones's locker.
Okay, who is this guy Davy with the locker anyway? Asked Beck. Some gym class reject?
Look, you guys, I shouted.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.